As the world looks to Philadelphia to celebrate the collection of Albert and Laura Barnes, we also want to celebrate their appreciation for the art form of gardening. While Albert Barnes was assembling his paintings and other pieces of art in the 1920s and 30s, his wife Laura Barnes was responsible for developing the garden. As the visual arts were the passion of Dr. Barnes, so horticulture was the passion of his wife. The 12-acre Arboretum was Laura's living landscape, her ever-changing art gallery. She recognized that gardening uses the trunks and stems of trees and shrubs to create structure, forms and shapes of leaves and needles to evoke texture, and that bursts of blooms and berries create pops of color in the garden. All these elements combine to paint the canvas of the garden. The Scott Arboretum of Swarthmore College, in concert with the Greater Philadelphia Gardens and with Art Philadelphia, wants to celebrate Garden as Art with a series of videos depicting five of our most artful gardens. Glimpse how plants create structure, color, and texture in our painting of the landscape.
Hi, welcome to another garden that we think is quite artful here at the Scott Arboretum. I'm standing at the edge of the Terry Shane Teaching Garden, which is special to those of us who work here because it's very near our office building, the headquarters of the Scott Arboretum. This garden came about from a special person as well. Terry Shane was one of the founders of the Associates of the Scott Arboretum, our friends group, and she lived in the Cunningham House for a number of years while her husband worked here at the college, and she was an active gardener, gardening around her home here. And after she left the college, she continued to garden until she was over 100 years old. But this garden given to us by her family and other supporters is a garden to give ideas about how to create a residential garden that bring together good plants from all of our collections here. The garden was created by Rodney Robinson, designed by Rodney Robinson, a landscape architect that now lives and works in the region. And it has two halves to it, or two different artful personalities to it. So let's take a look at those two sides of the Terry Shane Teaching Garden. So this half of the Teaching Garden has a formal personality to it. It's symmetrical. We can draw a line right down the middle of it and see that the borders are reflected on either side. And in this case, we have annuals that create an interest around this lawn panel at this lower level. Each year, we try to do something a little bit different to show how you can have a sense of change and a different artful sense to a garden such as this. So this year, we have a number of tropicals that have been planted into these borders. Bromeliads, bananas, tree ferns, begonias, plants along those lines. And then at the back of this, the trellis that you see, it creates a wonderful shaded spot to relax in the heat of the summer. And there's a canopy created by a native vine, a Dutchman's pipe with the large heart-shaped leaves that you see cascading down from that trellis. Then the edge of this formal area is defined by a clipped yew hedge. And it creates quite a separation between these two distinct personalities. So let's take a walk through the hedge and see the other half, the other artful personality of the Teaching Garden. As we come through the hedge to this half of the Teaching Garden, we enter a shaded side and an informal side. So we have random stones creating a terrace and a tapestry of ground covers, astilbes, hackanochloa, a number of different perennials that create an informal planting scheme on this side. There's also a bit of nature with the sound not only of the birds, but with the little water feature that we have here. We get a trickle of water coming through the sculpture with Mina the cat and the jug that she is transfixed on. So come and visit us at the Scott Arboretum to visit another artful garden, in this case the Terry Shane Teaching Garden.